ancient Greek and Roman statues had been colorful. Like Egyptians, like Oriental sculpture, the neighbors of Greece did produce color, so did the Greeks. There's still a lot of color preserved on the statues. You can see this with naked eyes. The Italian Renaissance wanted to get back into antiquity in pre-Christian era, and they wanted to have an iconic appearance of what they do. So they reanimated the antiquity, and they thought it would have been right.
The museums and the scholars didn't inform the public about color and ornament on the statues, since color and ornament had been, at a certain point, limited to non-European and non-earnest cultures, more folkloristic ones. In the beginning of the 20th century, you slowly understand when this radical new stance in aesthetic had been step by step developed. The European fascism is again contributing a lot in this by a high reluctance to accept detailed form, ornament, color differentiation. They tried to enhance the idea of a better culture of higher value in Europe. So everybody who tries to whitewash the Greek and Roman statuary is trying to establish a distinction which is false.
These works were heralded as exemplars, artistic exemplars, that provided universal, eternal models of beauty and ethical character for the present age. We still erect marble statues, all white, as one of the highest honors in contemporary society.
We understood a big misunderstanding, so we should continue and look for other misunderstandings. This is beautiful.